I feel like I've acquired a lot of information over a lot of really intense years of football.
Skills I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
I feel like I've acquired a lot of information over a lot of really intense years of football that people can actually apply in their everyday lives.
Outgate Patriots! Woo!
Well, some of them enthusiasm.
Wow. That's pretty impressive.
Wow.
Not again.
I'm German. I remember this play.
You do?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It was one of the easiest touchdown passes I've ever thrown. Okay. I didn't have to
do much.
I had to lob it up to Cordarrelle, caught it, took it to the house. I'm sure there was a lot of screaming, a lot of happiness. I know Foxborough was jacked up. So was I.
He is not prepped on this. This is one screenshot of something. We can go.
VonAllen Sports.
Tom Brady has a wet noodle for an arm right now. Say what it is. Let's just say what it is. So you have a quarterback who really can't throw the ball down the field very well.
Really?
Are you telling me I'm wrong about Brady being in decline?
Yeah, I'll take his wet noodle arm any day.
We all hate the Patriots.
There's an institutional arrogance.
Tom Brady would be a bum in short.
I hate Tom Brady.
No. That's not good enough.
Armstrong without the bicycle.
Most likely, those that came here hating Brady will forever hate him even if he cured cancer. But speaking of illnesses, I have a new term for those who suffer from Brady driving them insane. I call it BDS, Brady Derangement Syndrome. It basically means that no matter what, Tom will always be judged on a scale completely independent of every other quarterback, and they will criticize him as if he's in a vacuum. Let's get started. In this episode of Brady Hate, we're going to talk about the myth that Brady does not have the physical talent to survive in the old NFL. More often than not, NFL fans who hate Brady literally hate him more than they love their own team's quarterbacks. They get more pleasure watching the Patriots lose than they do their own team getting a victory. And this is due to the type of society we've changed into. Parents are raising kids to believe that they are victims, and if something doesn't go their way or they don't win, it's someone else's fault, or it's because someone cheated, or someone was favored over you. And thank you so much to Jason Patrick Saunders, and another military man, actually. But this guy isn't one of ours. He's from across the pond in the Royal Navy. Big props to our military guys. Much respect. Thank you. Big badass props to Rodney Frost. $20, tier 3. You got the tier that is the lunch break. I look forward to having that conversation. That's going to be awesome. Also, really smart person. I really enjoy his presence in our Facebook group. I really appreciate that too. Let's talk about the misconception that Brady doesn't have the physical gifts like arm strength and mobility. Many people assume if a player is outwardly grunting and straining while he's throwing the ball deep, then that means he's got a powerful arm. So, naturally, a quarterback who looks like they've barely even done anything when they're throwing a deep ball, people get the idea that it's a weak arm. The problem with this is that quarterbacks are very different in how they like to throw the ball. But in the end, they all get the same desired result for the most part. Brett Favre, for example. The strongest, most ridiculous arm I have ever seen. When Brett throws the ball hard, you can see it in his face. You can see his neck muscles popping. But that's Favre's style. He puts a lot of the responsibility for the power in his upper body. When he's on the run and he can still throw a 40-yard laser that never even gets higher than 5 feet from the ground, there's going to be some straining involved. Now, Favre is the most extreme case of this because he's elite regarding throwing power. It doesn't get more awesome than Brett Favre when it comes to that.
Yeah. I mean, boom! I mean, this is...
I should have probably taken a little off of it.
Doink! I mean...
They got on you quick. I'd admit that, yeah.
Now, when it comes to guys who make it look effortless, I'd say the extreme case of that would be Michael Vick. When you measure how little it looks he tried combined with the speed of the ball. And I remember watching him run around completely off balance with no real proper momentum for passing, and he still launched that thing. In fact, a lot of his passes were dropped by his receivers because he put too much power on them. You know you can throw hard when NFL players can't catch them. But Brady just does it different. He's not going to win any throwing power contest against Favre, Elway, or Stafford, or Warren Moon. His style of throwing is deceptive. Tom likes to stay in the pocket, so from there, he utilizes his entire body to make the long throws. He pulls energy from his feet,
to his legs, to his hips, his throwing motion, and his follow-through. He's learned how to make his entire body work as one machine that launches the ball. So doing this gives the appearance that he's not overexerting himself. But even more to the point, Brady is an elite NFL quarterback. All of these guys have good arms and have no problem landing a Hail Mary in the end zone when they have to. Tom also prefers accuracy over speed. The harder you throw it, the less accurate you become. But to quote sports science, when throwing, quarterbacks typically experience what is known as the speed-accuracy trade-off. Now, this is a general rule. There's always going to be exceptions. But this biomechanical principle states that as their movements increase speed, they become less accurate. Because we don't associate Tom with a rocket arm and the passes he throws has a really smooth gliding effect to it, people get the sense that he's not throwing hard or he can't throw hard. It's a deception to our eyes. This is why I am not a fan of when people say the eye test when criticizing NFL players. Our eyes lie to us every single day. Your eyes would tell you that Phillip Rivers is a terrible thrower of the football, which could lead to some assuming he's not even a good quarterback. But all we know about Rivers is that he's going to be in the Hall of Fame one day. And in Rivers' case, his form is so ugly that you would think he couldn't play. And in Brady's case, his form is so smooth and fundamental that no one thinks of him when it comes to throwing power. Tom's mechanics are so consistent that no matter the location of the target, it still takes only 0.39 hundredths of a second. Precision timing like this allows him to maintain his mechanics even when needing to throw crossing patterns at 61 miles per hour, which is more than 10 miles per hour faster than the typical hard pass in the NFL. So a lot of his passes, they kind of just glide their way over. It's deceiving, but it's not by a weak arm, it's by choice. And either way, it gets there, clearly. The other misconception about Brady is his lack of mobility. But the problem with mobility is it's a broad term.
Tom Brady has mobility like no other quarterback. Be able to move in the pocket. Let the play develop down the field. Watch Tom Brady. Haloti Ngata blitzes up the middle. Tom moves his left, buys time, then finds Dante Stallworth down the sideline.
Tom's pocket movement is some of the best the NFL has ever seen. Watch him closely when the D is hovering around him. He'll make one small step in one direction, and now he's totally free to make his throw. Ever notice how Brady always seems to know when someone is behind him? He ducks right at that moment.
Almost all of his runs are quarterback sneaks, and he's phenomenal at it.
Wait, Eddie! Wait!
Now, for a QB sneak, Tom transfers his body weight to his right leg and pushes as the center executes the snap. Now, this allows him to push his left leg back and move forward off the ground just 0.05 of a second after the ball is snapped. By dropping his center of mass and generating 800 pounds of force with each step, Brady can get the ball across the line of scrimmage in about 0.75 of a second. That's awesome. And then from there, Tom just wedges himself in between his center and his guard. He's 6'4", man, and he just goes right in. And it's almost unstoppable. You know, that's why you always see him convert it every time. It's like when it's fourth and short, you see Tom, he's just so good at it.
But I think the one that would mean the most might be the 1,000-yard rusher.
Okay, but to put this in perspective, if you just want to know how good Tom is at this, consider. Now, when this sports science episode was done, Marshawn Lynch was still in the NFL. On third or fourth down, with two or fewer yards to gain, Lynch has a conversion rate of about 60%. And Tom, who had just about as many attempts as well at the time, he has a 91.9% conversion rate. And that, at the time, was the highest of any active player. Now, I know that it's a little different because Tom is taking the snap immediately and it's unexpected, and yet Marshawn has to wait for the handoff. So we're not saying that it's, you know, exactly that's like a definitive statistic or something. It's just a fun thing just to kind of compare and get you the idea that, wow, that's pretty awesome, you know?
Although he's not considered fast, I consider him to be very mobile.
The eye test comes into play when Brady makes the occasional on-the-run throws. Tom isn't going to get any awards for flashiest or coolest-looking highlight reel quarterback. Those things are going to go to Aaron Rodgers or Patrick Mahomes, guys like that. 15 years ago, that was Brett Favre's domain. But people take this to mean that Tom can't do those things. When he does them, yes, he often looks a bit awkward doing it. But it's the same exact play with the same exact result, but no one is going crazy about it. The commentators aren't fawning over him like it's the greatest play ever. But when Rodgers does it, it's hail to the king with the exact same play.
Andy Reid, what a throw, what a route. Mahomes, look at that torque. Oh my goodness, that was outstanding on so many levels.
All kinds of time for Brady to go for it. To the end zone!
And he runs it out and up, and he beats Nelson bad. And Brady knows the corner's not looking, so you just make sure not overthrow him. Mahomes, look at that torque! Look at that torque! Torque! Oh my goodness, that was outstanding at so many levels. Oh my goodness, that was outstanding at so many levels.
This is called style points. See, I'm showing you the same air yardage from these quarterbacks, but they have a different feel to them. One seems more impressive, more aggressive than the other. You know, Dan Marino stayed in the pocket and he got by just fine. He played a long career without running out of the pocket to escape. So how in the world can you say Brady's lack of scrambling ability would cost him back then? It doesn't make much sense. Now, they found that Tom can fire his arm forward at the same angular velocity as a major league pitcher, but still hit a target the size of a dinner plate. That is insane. Just how good he is and how good a lot of these quarterbacks are. It's just amazing, you know? Really, 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 they need to focus more on these types of things so the fans can really understand just how good these guys are. It's not just, it's like the check down Alex thing, you know? They make fun of Alex, calling Mr. Check Down Alex and all this stuff. They have no idea the thought mechanism that's going on and how Alex is preparing for that game and what he sees. So all you see is a check down, or what you think is a check down, but most people use that incorrectly anyway. But what you think you see is a simple 2-yard pass or whatever. And it's not like that. It's about being aware. There's so much more into it. It is worth noting, just to defend Alex, that the year that everyone was calling him check down Alex, he had the most big deep throws or deep completions in the league. There's also the case of defensive evolution. The schemes are more complex. Defensive backs are on a whole other level than most of the DBs back then. Back in the day, most defensive backs were just wide receivers who couldn't catch, converted over. But those days are gone. Now, kids are mastering the craft early as a defensive back. It's no longer something that is given to them as a default consolation prize in order for them to get to play. Tom is out there making these guys confused and crazy. Imagine what he would do back then with those DBs. And not just Tom, put Peyton back there. Put Drew Brees back there. Put Aaron Rodgers back there. These guys would thrive. Teams are constantly working around the clock to stop these guys, but it doesn't seem to matter. Every time it seems the league caught up with one of these guys, they switch it to something else. Tom is a master at this.
I think what Tom has the ability to do is to go to the line and assess the situation.
He's mastered the game. This man has seen every coverage. He's seen every type of game plan you can come up against him with. You might as well stop wasting your time.
For almost 10 days, he got a click in his hand, and he's clicking.
He's clicking.
Yep. To find where your weakness is. Yep. And if you are not sitting down clicking like he clicking, if he clicking 5 hours and you clicking one, you ain't winning this battle. Mm-hmm. See, this is a chess player. Mm-hmm. Brady's that's what makes this guy so hard to defend. He gonna run down the field and let you know, I'm glad you talking. To say, how do you beat a master? You must study a master. How do you study a master? It takes a lot of time. The one thing Tom Brady and Peyton Manning made me do was sit my behind down. Keep Brady on there with a coat on and Foxborough on the sideline.
Well, that's your best defense.
You better do some film study and some prayers because Brady's about to make it rain.
Every year, Tom shows up week one with some type of improvement. It's crazy. He's like Samus in Metroid. What defense are you going to throw at these guys that they can't destroy? But what I want to say again, this video is in no way disrespect to the quarterbacks who played before. This is only to address the disrespect paid to modern era quarterbacks who are accused of being soft. I truly believe Dan Marino would have been great in any era. He, in my opinion, is the greatest pure passer of all time. I know people keep saying Aaron Rodgers, but I'm sorry. See? I'm giving the nod to an older guy for once, right? I think Warren Moon is another guy who would have dominated right now if he hadn't got sent to Canada for so many years simply because of the stigma that black guys can't play quarterback. His stats would have been even more ridiculous. But trying to say someone is the greatest quarterback of all time, well, that includes a lot of different things.
Things have changed a little bit, but if it's changed a lot enough, there'd be a lot more guys doing it, right? But it's still not as easy as everybody thinks. Yeah.
So, let's see what Belichick thinks about Brady being the GOAT.
He's earned everything that he's achieved. He's a very smart, instinctive football player.
But he might end up being the greatest of all time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Notice, Brady here is voicing his opinion and ultimately getting his way. Belichick listened, agreed, and then did it.
How many kicked a field goal?
40-yarder, game's over.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Go field goal, Steve, field let's go. Goal.
You can see the unselfishness from Brady. Do you have any idea how many quarterbacks would want the ball in their hands just so they can secure the MVP, despite being ahead by a touchdown? Brady didn't care about that at all. He only cared about winning. He doesn't care if there's a field goal, so more of you haters can say he needs a kicker. He wants the victory, and that is it. Look at his reaction to Sony Michel's touchdown run. Brady acts as if he just threw the touchdown pass himself. So it's not that Brady can't do it, it's that he plays the odds for that situation. It's never about him, it's about the team. If you would like to support the channel in more ways, you can visit our Patreon in the description of this video. You can also purchase merchandise from us, which if you send a picture of yourself with it, I will put it in the next video. You can also support by purchasing music, which all links for these is in the description. You guys are awesome, and you have no idea how appreciative I am that you always comment and interact with me. I am really enjoying this work, all because of you guys. Thank you so much.
What's up, buddy?
How you doing, big guy? Good to see you, man.
How are you, dude?
Doing good, man.
I got so much. I want to be out here against you so bad.
Vice versa. I feel the same way.
Hey, listen, I've never done this before, but I would love to get a jersey somewhere.
Sure. I mean, let's do it. I'll get you after the game.
Not many that I want. I'm with my office.
I feel the same way.
Wish you the best.
Good luck.
Hopefully we'll see you again, all right?
Yeah.
Trying to get them 1,000 yards, boy. Okay.
Touchdown.
How do you say touchdown?
Touchdown.
Well, then I do speak German. Touchdown.
Can you show the people, how does it feel to be Tom Brady?
VonAllen Sports?
VonAllen Sports.